They put you in handcuffs then?
I think that's standard operating procedure until they figure out what's going on.
A state lawmaker in some hot water over a used car deal, an argument, and a gun.
We got our hands on court documents late this evening that show Minnesota House Republican leader Kurt Daudt was placed under arrest in Montana in September.
RJ Coles is the only reporter who talked to Daudt today about what happened. He's live from the state capitol now with the exclusive. Jay?
Ellen, these court documents out of Montana, written by a county attorney, do say that House Minority Leader Kurt Daudt was arrested for a brief period. Now, Representative Daudt says he admits he was read his rights and he was placed in handcuffs, but he says he was never arrested and he was never booked into jail. Now, the friend he was traveling with, who's also named in this criminal complaint, he faces three felonies. He's in much bigger trouble right now. And this is the life up here at the Capitol. It kind of goes with the territory. When you're elected to a top official as a leadership position, you're going to be under a microscope up here.
In a candid interview, Minority Leader Kurt Daudt tells me he did nothing wrong, but was caught in the middle of an unfortunate situation. That situation happened last September when he and a friend traveled to Montana to buy an old Ford Bronco.
You know, without my knowledge or without my permission, went back to my vehicle and took a handgun out and then upon feeling further threatened, in kind of a defensive manner, he displayed the handgun.
Daudt says he and his friend thought they were being cheated on the sale. And Daudt says the owner of the vehicle became aggressive, and that's when his friend pulled out the gun.
Obviously, that's not something that anybody does lightly. I can't speak for him, but I think he felt scared in the situation and ultimately felt threatened.
Daudt says he tried to defuse the situation and was a peacemaker, even though it was his gun being used by his friend.
It is a very unfortunate situation, and I've relived it in my head numerous times, but ultimately, I think, I kind of go back to their statement and everything that I did, as scary as the situation was at the time, everything that I did, I think I handled myself very, very appropriately.
Did your friend point the gun at him? Was it loaded?
He did not. He took it out. It did not have a bullet in the chamber. It did have some in the magazine.
But these court documents say Daudt's friend pointed the gun at the entire family, including minor children. The court documents also say authorities pulled Daudt and his friend over on I-90 and placed them under arrest. Daudt insists he was not arrested.
Why did they put you in handcuffs then?
I think that's standard operating procedure until they figure out what's going on.
Phil Krenke served in the House and was an assistant minority leader for the Republican Party. He told me Daudt should have come forward right away for his colleagues and his constituents and not waited 5 months.
Obviously, in this situation, not something that probably the minority leader wanted to come forward with.
And again, we want to emphasize Representative Daudt was not charged with any crime in this incident. Again, the court records say he was arrested for a brief time. Representative Daudt also disputes that. Now, his friend that was traveling with him, again, as I mentioned, is in much bigger trouble. He faces three charges in this complaint: aggravated assault, aggravated assault with a weapon, and criminal endangerment. Reporting live in St. Paul at the state capitol, Jay Coles, 5 Eyewitness News.
You can read the legal documents and watch Jay's full interview with the House Minority Leader by going to KSTP.com and clicking quick links. This isn't the first time that we've heard about one of our state representatives having a run-in with the law over a gun. Back in December of 2010, House Republican Tom Hackbarth was spotted on surveillance video with a loaded gun on his hip outside of a Planned Parenthood. Hackbarth does have a permit to carry a gun. He told police and 5 Eyewitness News that he was checking up on a woman that he met online. St. Paul police took his gun away, saying that his behavior was suspicious and no charges were ever filed.
9 months.